students, in the last video we finished the topic complexity of algorithms. In this video we will start with the new topic, that is recursive function. First of all, we should know that what are recursive functions. If an object can be defined in terms of itself, then that process is known as recursion. That object may be any algorithm, sequence or any function. We have already discussed that an algorithm can be written in its iterative form or in its recursive form. In recursive form, we solve the problem by reducing it to an instance of the same problem with smaller inputs. From this picture, you can easily analyze the concept of recursion, that an object is defined in terms of itself. Similarly, for second picture like this. Every recursive definition will have two parts. First is the basic case, second is the recursive case. The most primitive cases of the entity are defined in the basic case. They do not refer to the entity. Whereas in recursive case, the new cases of the entity are defined in terms of the simpler cases by referring to the entity itself. A recursive sequence is an ordered list of objects which is potentially infinite. In a recursive sequence, we define the sequence recursively by explicitly naming the first value or some values in the sequence and then defining the later values in the sequence in terms of the earlier values. Like in the first example, here we have base case, that is S1 equal to 2. So value of S1 is 2 and Sn is defined as twice of S of n minus 1. So we can say that S2 will be equal to twice of S1, that is 2, which is 4. Similarly, S3 will be equal to twice of S2. So that is 2 into 4, which is equal to 8, and so on. So our sequence will be 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on. In the second example, we have the base case t1 equal to 1 and tn is equal to t of n minus 1 plus 3. So we can say that t2 will be equal to t of 2 minus 1, which is t1 plus 3, that is equal to 4 because t1 is 1. Similarly, t3 will be equal to 4 plus 3, that is 7, and t4 will be equal to 7 plus 3, that is 10. So our sequence will be 1, 4, 7, 10 and so. Now some important functions can be defined recursively. For example, first is factorial function. If we want to calculate factorial 4, then that is equal to 4 into factorial 3. So we have to calculate factorial 3 now, which will be equal to 3 into factorial 2. Similarly, factorial 2 will be equal to 2 into factorial 1. Now we have to stop. So our base case will be factorial 1 is equal to 1 and we will calculate the later value. So recursive definition of this function will be f of 1 is equal to 1 and f of n is equal to n into f of n minus 1, where n is greater than equal to 2. Second, Fibonacci numbers. We know that Fibonacci series is 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, so on. That is, the nth term is equal to sum of two previous terms. So in this case, we will have two values in the base case. That is, f of 1 is 1 and f of 2 is also 1. Now, f of n will be equal to f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2 for all n greater than equal to 3. For example, if we want to calculate the third term, that is f3, that will be equal to f2 plus f1. So f3 is equal to f2, that is 1, plus f1, that is 1, so it is equal to 2. Similarly, f4 will be equal to f3 plus f2, so that is equal to 2 plus f2, that is 1, so which is 3. So our sequence is 1, 1, 2, 3 and so. So we can define these two important functions recursively. Another example, here we have been given f naught is equal to 3 and f of n plus 1 is equal to twice of f n plus 3. We have to calculate f of 2. That is, we will put n is equal to 1 in this recursive case. So we will get f of 1 plus 1, that is 2, is equal to twice of f1 plus 3. But f1 is not known. So we have to calculate f of 1 first. So f1 will be equal to, put n is equal to 0 in this equation. We will get f1 is equal to twice of f0 plus 3. So which will come out to be 2 into 3 plus 3, which is 9. So put f1 is equal to 9 in this recursion. We will get f2 is equal to twice of 9 plus 3, which is equal to 20. Now, in this example, we have been given a sequence and we have to find the recursive definition. Sequence is 1, 2, 4, 7, 11, 16, 22. If we analyze this sequence, then we can say that if f of 1 is 1, then f2 will be equal to 1 plus 1, which is f1 plus 1. Similarly, f3, that is third term, is equal to f2 plus 2, because 4 is 2 plus 2. Similarly, f4, that is fourth term, is equal to f3, which is 4 plus 3, which will come out to be 7. So we can say that our recursive definition of this sequence is f1 is equal to 1 and fn is equal to fn minus 1 plus n minus 1 for all n greater than equal to 2. Now we will define two special recursive functions. First is Ackermann function and second is MacArthur function. Definition of Ackermann function is a of mn is equal to n plus 1 if m is equal to 0, and it is equal to a of m minus 1 comma 1 if m is greater than 0 and n is equal to 0, and the value is equal to a of m minus 1 comma a of m comma n minus 1 if both m and n are greater than 0. Now let us take one example in which, suppose we have m equal to 1, n equal to 2. We have to calculate a of mn, that is a of 1, 2. So here our third case will apply, which will be equal to a of m minus 1, that is 0, comma a of m, that is 1, comma n minus 1, that is 2 minus 1, which is 1. Now this is another function, Ackermann function, which we have to solve first. So this will be equal to a of 0 comma, when both m and n are 1. Then again third case will apply. So this value will be equal to a of m minus 1, which is 0, comma a of m, that is 1, comma n minus 1, which is 0. Now again we have to solve this one. In this case, which case will apply? Our second case, because m is greater than 0 and n is equal to 0. So value will be a of 0 comma a of 0 comma, now a of 1 0, that is m equal to 1, n equal to 0. Applying second case, we will get a of m minus 1, that is 0 comma 1. Then we have to solve this function first. It will be equal to a of 0 comma a of 0 comma a of 0 1. 0 1 means m is 0. So this is equal to n plus 1, which is 2. Now solving this, again first case will apply. This is equal to n plus 1, which is 3. So this will be a 0 3. Again first case will apply. Here n is 3. So this is equal to n plus 1, which is 4. Hence 4 is the value for Ackermann function when m and n are equal to 1 and 2 respectively. सेकेंड मैकार्थे फंक्शन. मैकार्थे फंक्शन इज डिफाइंड एज एम ऑफ एन इज इक्वल टू एन माइनस टेन इफ एन इज ग्रेटर देन 100 एंड इज इक्वल टू एम ऑफ एन प्लस 11 इफ एन इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 100. सो वी विल सॉल्व इट फॉर एन इज इक्वल टू 99. वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एम ऑफ 99. So here second case will apply, which is equal to m of n plus 11, that is equal to m of 110. Now when value of n is 110, then this will be equal to n minus 10, because applying first case, that is equal to m of 110 minus 10, that is m of 100. Then again second case will apply, which is equal to m of n plus 11, that is 111. Now again solving this, first case will apply, which is equal to n minus 10, so this is 101. Then again first case will apply, which is equal to 101 minus 10, that is 91. So the value of Mccarthy function for n equal to 99 is 91. You can solve this Mccarthy function for any value of n ranging from 1 to 101. You will get the value of function as 91. That is why it is known as Mccarthy 91. So we can say that value of Mccarthy 91 function is equal to 91 if n is less than equal to 101 and it is equal to n minus 10 if n is greater than 101. So hope the concepts of recursive functions are clear to you. In the next video we will discuss about the hashing functions.